What's up, guys? My name is George, and this is SaaS Master. Today, we're going to check out Tutor LMS, which is a learning management system from Themium. Now, what we're going to do is show you a quick overview of how you can create your own courses really fast and really easy. This is a WordPress plugin that it's easy and straightforward. And I'll be honest with you, I thought it was going to be really complicated since there's so many things going on in Tutor LMS, but it's actually pretty easy and straightforward. And I'm going to show you that really quick. Now, before we head on over to the user interface of Tutor LMS, I want to show you some interesting facts here on Tutor LMS page. Now, if you guys want to grab this deal, the link will be in the description, so check it out. It's an affiliate link, it's going to give me a small commission, and it won't cost you 1 cent more. So it's just going to help me out, keep making these videos. So the first thing that you're going to see is, well, it's a smart and simple scalable WordPress LMS. Everything is like straight and forward, drag and drop when you create this build with these courses, so it's easy. Advanced quiz creator. So that means when a person is doing the course, you can set them up with a quiz along with it. So it's pretty cool because you let them know that they're actually doing good or bad and they can take it over again. So it makes it more interactive in a sense. You got front end course builder. So you can see this right here. We got the easy learning management. So you can see you can manage everything like control courses enrollment, add multiple instructors, set courses requirements. Reports and analytics, so you know how many people are signed up, how they're going, how they're learning, and all that good stuff. Withdrawal options, so if you're setting up this to do this for a third party, so for example, someone is doing the courses, you set up the Tutor LMS and people can sign up and upload their own courses, so you can set up withdrawal options. You got e-learning commissions and allocation, same as I did before and showed you. So let's head on over to the dashboard. Once you install Tutor LMS, it's pretty easy and straightforward. Head on over to plugins. Where's this? Sorry, plugins. Add new and add Tutor LMS to it. Add the license and you're ready to go. So what we're gonna do right now, I'm gonna show you really quick how it's easy to set up. This is not my main course. I'm still cooking my courses and I don't wanna give it away. So I'm gonna do this with a brand new site. So let's add a brand new course. And what you're gonna do is set title. In this case, I'm just gonna say test. And like I said, it's easy and straightforward. It's just going one after the other. So the course settings, you got maximum students. How many students do you wanna set this for? 0 would be unlimited. I guess that would be the most popular option, but you might wanna do a course that, hey, you know what? Only 10 people can join this course, or 100 people. You can set that there. Difficulty level. So you wanna say, hey, this is for beginners, for intermediate, expert, or all levels. Next thing we got is the all products. So in this case, you can set it to a product. In this case, I'll just link it to this one right here. And is it gonna be a paid course or a free course? I'm just gonna say free for now. Course builder. Now, this is where the fun starts, all right? This is the most important part of all. This is where you're gonna build it. So we're gonna add a brand new topic. And the topic name would be phone unlocking in this case, right? Topic summary. So learn how to unlock phones. All right, so we're gonna add the topic. Now that we've added the topic, you can see this right here, we're gonna add a brand new lesson to this topic. So in this case, we'll just set draft lesson 1, right? You call it whatever you want. And this is where all the information goes. So in this case, you'd say, you know what, you start your course, all the good information. I'll just put whatever right now. You can upload a featured image. Let's just grab one from right here. Let's grab these phones right here. Set that there. Let's go down here. You can select a video source. So if you have a video for this learning course that you're creating, you can grab it from HTML5 and MP4. So that means it's directly in uploaded on your hosting. So you can upload there. External URL, a YouTube URL. So if you have a video going on over there, you can grab from there. A Vimeo or an embedded. I'm gonna grab a YouTube URL just because I want to show you how this works. Let me go right here. Let me search. All right, I'm gonna grab this one, which is my video.
What's up?
All right, I'm gonna copy this and close it. So I'm gonna put the link right here and the playback time. We're gonna leave it as it is. Upload attachments. So if you want to upload like a PDF, a word that's gonna go along with your course. So let's just say, for example, you know what, they gotta fill out something in physically right here. So maybe it's a course about how to write. So you know what, you give them the template and they can do that. So let's update this lesson. Okay, that's created. We can add another lesson. So let's just say draft lesson number two. So right here. And also information. We're not gonna put the other stuff. Just gonna update that. And you add all the lessons. Now, like I said, this is the most part where you're gonna add the most content there, because this is actually where the course is going to be uploaded. And along with this, you can create quizzes. So in this quiz, I think it's a pretty awesome option that Tutor LMS has this, because let's just say it's a quick quiz. All right, let's go to next. Questions. So what are the questions gonna be for this quiz? So in this case, it's the question type. So we got the option for true or false. We got single option, multiple choices, open-end essay, fill in blanks, short answers, matching image answering, and ordering. So you have all these options to create your quiz. So it's pretty interactive that you have this. Is it gonna be image based? So for example, you can set like 3 images, 4 images, and you can select the one that belongs to the answer. So that's pretty cool. Or just use true and false, which is easy. Answer required. Is it gonna be randomized? Points that this answered question is going to give you. You can display the points. The description is available. And you can answer options. So you can see right here, select the correct option, true or false. So you can save the answer and you can create it. Also, you write here the question. Easy and straightforward. Let's just save this. And you can add more quizzes if you want. So this is another question right here. So that one's a true or false. This one is going to be image answering. So let's just say, what is the best phone? An example. Answered is required. This one will give you 3 points, display options, and you upload the images here. So I'll just add this one, and then, whoops, sorry. This one, answered value, which is a 1, save the option. Let's add another one, right? Another image. It's gonna be this one over here. Remember, this is just for testing purposes. 2, save the answer. And 3. Oops, sorry. Select it and answer type 3. Save answer. Now you can see now that we've created images, obviously you would set the images based on what your course is about. Let's click next. Now you can set the time limit for this. Are we gonna do it unlimited, or are we gonna say, you know what? It's a pretty short one, you got 10 minutes. If you actually learn what I'm showing you, you have to answer in 10 minutes, right? Hide quiz time if you don't want to display it. Attempts allowed, so that means this is optional. You can remove this or keep it at 10. Passing grade, so this actually graded. If you want them to actually pass, they have to reach at least 80%, 90, 70, whatever you want. Max questions allowed to answers, and you're set to go. Save. Let's save that right there. All right, close. And now that we have here the course builder, we got lesson 1, lesson 2, and we have a quiz. Now we can drag and drop these if we want. So if we create later more lessons, we can set the quiz to the end or in the middle or in between or whatever you want. Also, you can add more topics. So this topic was a phone unlocking, and you just create as many topics as you want. Now, what I like about the builder is that we have all these options to build it. You got the paragraph, you got size, you got bold, italic, center, you got all the options available, even HTML to create your course. So it's pretty advanced options. All right, next is additional data. So total course duration, hours, minutes, seconds. So in this case, it's gonna take 1 hour. Benefits of the course. So what are you gonna benefit from this? Now this is really good information that you have to think and fill it out with something that's attractive to people. Why is this? Because let me head on over here. So if I head on over to this course that I already created, this information is gonna be here. So you can see right here, courses, and people are gonna just read and check out, okay, what is it about? And then I'm gonna decide if I'm gonna join or not. So benefits, learn to be the best unlocker, right? Just based on what I'm talking about. Requirements or instructions. In this case, you're gonna need a phone, you're gonna need paper, you're gonna need a computer, so on and so forth. Whatever your course is about is what you said. Target audience, so who is this for? Phone shops. Materials included. In this case, we're gonna include like videos, you can say videos, PDF, Word, template. You can say like a list of companies, list of companies, so on and so forth. Course intro video. Now this course intro video, you can see right here, I've added this video. So if they click play, it'll just play right there. I won't do it right now. But this is where you set that URL. I'm gonna post that one I showed. And you have all the options right here also. Announcements. These announcements I'm not gonna use right now, but where would they be? If I head over here, you can see this is the course and there's announcements right here. I think I haven't posted anything, but let's just say for example, hey, you know what? There's a brand new announcement. We just updated the course to version 2, or check out the brand new lesson that's been added. Don't skip this lesson. And this is where you would do announcements. And the instructors. In this case, I haven't added instructors or they haven't signed up. You can add manually right here if you want to set it to someone, and you're good to go. Let me put this in this category. And if I want to create a brand new category here, you do that. Let me save that and show you how that looks. All right, let's go here to the courses link. Let's go to incognito mode and let's click on this one that I've created. And you can see right here, you can have the information. And like I told you, it's really important that you set the description. So in this case, I just said testing this LMS, but what you want to do is set something really attractive, like I told you before. In this case, you can see the topics of this course. So phone unlocking, sorry, this is a pop-up. Let me remove that. All right, phone unlock, what did you learn? Draft lesson 2. You can see who the instructor is. You can set the image. You can see the rating of this instructor. On the right, we have the featured video. So it's gonna, you can record a really nice video that's gonna tell you about this course specifically. This one is free, materials included, video and quizzes, requirements, learning capacity, phone in hand, target audience, phone shots, phone technicians, and all that. All right, so let's just say you like what you see. And what we're gonna do is enroll right here, and we're not gonna log in because... And what we're gonna do now is enroll right here, and we can log in or we can create a brand new user. So what I'm gonna do is create the brand new user and I'll be back. All right, now that we've enrolled on this course, what I'm going to do is start the course. So I'm gonna start it right now. And you can see it's really interactive and nice. You can see it. You can also change those colors if you want. So we got the lesson list right here, which is what did you learn? So you can see it takes 10 minutes. Draft lesson, 7 minutes, and draft lesson 2. So in this case, let's start draft lesson. Click on that. And in this case, I have whatever video I have available. But in this case, you would put your video course right now and all the information down here about this course. Also, you can do the attachments like I've done right here. So once you fill that out and you say, you know what, it's completed. I saw all the course and it's completed. I click on that, so I have this. But let's go back to lessons list. Click on that, lessons list. What did you learn? And I want to show you what this quiz is about. So let's click on the start quiz. And you can see right here that it's the quiz that we've built. Now it's going to be as long and as short as you like. And you can see right here, we got the question 1, which is can phones be unlocked with the server? In this case, I said a true or false one. I know that true would be the right one, so I'm going to say true. And I'm going to submit quiz. If it were longer, then we go to the next question and the next question. So in this case, you can see it was pass number 4. And since we have attempts remaining, so we did 3 attempts and we have 7 remaining until we pass. So we have all this information that we can see. So it's pretty cool and straightforward that we have all this. Also, you got the browse question and answer. So if you have questions based on this course, you can ask a question right here and set that there. So as you can see, it was easy and straightforward to do this. And just so we finish off, I'm gonna show you the settings options right here and the add-ons that you can add right here. So in settings, there's a whole bunch of things that you can set up right here, which is general, so dashboard page, public profile, load tutor CSS, all this good stuff. But the things I wanna show you, let me show you right here, styling. So in styling, you can change the primary color, primary hover color, text color, and light color. Monetization options, WooCommerce options, and email notification options. all those stuff you can check out and customize to your liking. You have all these available add-ons that obviously you add if you need and you keep off if you don't need them. So you can add a content drip, you can add an enrollment option, a grade book, a paid membership pro. You need this one, right? Assignments, certificates. So in certificates is pretty cool because if you want to give your users, once they're done, a cool certificate, you can do it right here. You can course attachments, course review, email, multi-instructors, pre-quiz sites, reports, and WooCommerce to subscriptions options. So if you add the subscription option, that means you can have a paid recurring. So that means if you want to sell your course and say, hey, you got to pay monthly, you can set it there with this option. So there you go, guys. Tutor LMS, a really, really powerful LMS WordPress plugin. Easy, straightforward. I thought, like I told you, I'd be honest, I thought it was going to be way more complicated, but it's not. I'm in the course, I'm like 50% almost finished with the course I'm building for myself. But like I said, I can't show it yet because you know how people are, no? Once you show it, people steal your idea. So I want to be the first one to hit it there. So once it's going to be available, I'll put the link in the description of this video for that course once it's done. Okay guys, my name is George, this is SaaS Master, and this is Tutor LMS. If you guys want to grab it, the link will be in the description. See you guys later.